Ross, getting close to playoff time again. This is a very exciting time, I suppose, when you know you're still in the running, whereas other teams are starting to prepare for resting and things like that.
Yeah, it's always nice being in the playoffs. This is what you work so hard for throughout the whole season. The guys are fired up, ready to go, and for us, every single game, especially starting this weekend, is a playoff. So, quite excited.
What have you made of the Bulls, especially their win over the Jaguars? You guys must have been rooting for them this past weekend as well.
I think it's the first time the whole of Joburg was rooting for the Bulls. But yeah, well done to them. They're playing great rugby at the moment. It's going to be a difficult game this weekend. They've got a couple of good combinations that have really started to click. Very excited.
Do you reckon, you're going to come up against probably one or even both of the current Springbok scrum halves as well? Is that, I know it's not a one-on-one thing, it's more a team thing, but are you looking forward to that?
Yeah, obviously you're always up for the challenge. I think the game's evolved so much these days that you've got to stick into your specific space. Sorry, I thought I'd restart that over.
I think you're going to come up against both the current Springbok scrum halves at some point. That must excite you, then?
Yeah, it's definitely exciting playing against quality players. Both of them have had a great season for the Bulls and got their chances here to represent the country. So well done to the two of them. Just excited to get on the park this weekend and play some good rugby with the boys.
Having been a Springbok last year, now this year being out of the picture and so on, is there for you that still that huge motivation to sort of get back in that green and gold jersey?
Definitely. If there wasn't that motivation, I think pretty much every single player would be going overseas. You always want to play for the Springboks. You want to play at the top level, and you want to play against the best. So. There's always that motivation and drive. If it happens, great. If it doesn't, you can only control what you can control.
Talking about going overseas, are you one of the Lions thinking of going overseas or going overseas?
Actually not going overseas.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if it's
Well, you might as well.
So I've signed for another 2 years here at the Lions. Absolutely love it here in Joburg. My family's here, the bushes are on the corner, the beaches, and I always fly away. So, yeah, and the sun's up pretty much all day, every day. So, I love it.
I can imagine you, somebody that would have had offers to go overseas, and obviously it's for other players very lucrative to go, the pound against the rand or the euro or whatever. You've now touched on what made you decide to stay on Ceylon, but overall, what's your sort of thinking on this whole thing of going overseas?
Obviously going overseas, a rugby career is so long, and you've got to make the most of it. However, if you still have a dream of playing in a World Cup or performing at the highest level against the best, obviously you want to be here and competing in Super Rugby, which I believe only improves your game and is one of the hardest competitions in the world. You've also got to think about your family one day and worry about your future, and it sets you up for life after rugby, but at the same time, if you are smart, you can set yourself up here and play professional rugby here.
How much of what the Lions have achieved and have created in terms of a conducive atmosphere here is still a draw card for players to stay here?
Well, look, I mean, I think everybody wants to be here at the Lions. I'm not sure from guys at other unions, but you ask any guy that's leaving here, there's a sad pull in that they've got a solo. I think a lot of the guys that are leaving are doing it purely for their families. Otherwise, everybody would stay here at the Lions.
Ross, you were one of the couple of guys that got injured during the course of the campaign. How do you feel? How disruptive was that for the Lions?
Look, I think we've got amazing depth here at the Lions. I think that's one of our strengths, and there have been quite a couple of injuries this year, but there have been guys that have just slotted in and really stuck up their hand, and the guys that have got the opportunity, I mean, it's creating a good position for Coach Swayze to worry about picking a team every single weekend. So it's a great problem to have.
The fact that you're on the cusp of playoffs now, obviously over the last few years you've become accustomed to playing in playoffs. Does that help? I mean, does it make it any easier when you go into a quarter or a semi?
Definitely. I mean, experience, you ask anyone. Have a look at the 2007 South African team that won the World Cup. The amount of experience in that team was incredible. And I think the amount of experience in the Lions team at the moment with a couple of exciting youngsters is just incredible. And I mean, if we can keep growing and keep moving forward the way we're doing things now, it's only going to get better.
Would you have preferred a bit of momentum going into the quarter?
I think we're going to be peaking at the right time. I still don't think that we've clicked 100% this year, and I'm hoping that it's going to happen now leading up to the playoffs.
Ross, depending on what happens over the weekend, you can either after Saturday be 2nd or 7th, you know. How do you as players, is that something that you guys think of in a lead up to a week like that, or is it just focus on the one thing you've got to do, and that's try and beat the Bulls on Saturday?
I think every player is different. For me, it's just focus on the job at hand. Whatever happens after this weekend, if we've got to go overseas and play there, we've got to go do a job, and that's that. However, it would be nice to have a home quarter final, get the crowd and our support around us. I mean, it's the best stadium to play at in the entire world. We'd like to have a home quarters, but if we don't, then we've still got a job at hand to do.
Nothing at stake really for the Bulls except maybe pride, but for you guys a lot at stake. Is it a case of more pressure on you, on the team?
Look, I think this whole year there's been a lot of pressure on us. Every single game that we've gone out to and gone into, every single team has been wanting to beat us. So literally we have not had an easy game the whole year, and we've had to get ourselves up every single game. So yeah, the Bulls don't have anything to play for except for pride, but I still do believe that they would like to get one over us, as I don't think it's happened in a while. So yeah.